In this video, I will review and test the newest laser from Sculpfun, the Sculpfun SF-A9, a 40-watt octadiode laser engraver. The machine comes partially assembled, and you just need to attach the X-axis bridge to the frame, which takes just a few minutes. At the first glance, the Sculpfun SF-A9 looks like a premium laser engraver. Everything looks and feels solid. Sculpfun is really becoming a mature laser engraver manufacturer. The machine is very solidly built. It has very nice belt tensioners and steel rollers on Y-axis, which features spring-loaded design which does not need adjusting. The X-axis features the industrial linear sliding rail, which has proven to be an excellent upgrade on earlier models. It also has large stepper motors which enable this machine to reach speeds up to 36,000 millimeters per minute. You also get machine risers, a spare lens for the laser module, an air assist, and other standard items. Even the power supply looks like a high-quality one. It also has great cable management. All cables are neatly hidden and don't get in the way when the machine is working. It is a well-thought-out machine, and all cables are routed so that they do not obstruct the machine's operation. Even the control panel has connectors turned backwards, so they don't stick out like on all other laser engravers. The air assist hose also comes out very conveniently on the side. The first thing I noticed is that this laser module has a switch which enables you to switch between two power modes, allowing you to engrave with lower power, which results in smaller focus spot size. This laser module has a very effective heat sink, which is needed to dissipate the heat that the 8 laser diodes are producing. On the side, you have a small tab which is used for focusing the module, and on the top side, you will find the interface connectors. The laser module holding bracket has a fine adjustment knob which is used for precise focus adjustments. The Sculpfun SF-A9 laser engraver has a very elegant control panel consisting of emergency stop switch, a power button, and a key lock which prevents unauthorized people or children from operating the machine. Let's look at the laser module in more detail. The correct focus distance is set by this rotating lever. The module is tightened by a red tightening lever for quick focus adjustments. For fine focus adjustments, you can use the fine adjustment screw and a nice measuring ruler printed on the side of the module. This is a very convenient system for lowering the focus for laser cutting. Now let's turn on the machine and see what it is all about. Upon turning on the machine, I immediately noticed one of the coolest features I haven't seen on any other machine. The air assist pump is constantly working at minimum speed, which is great for engraving as it prevents the smoke from entering the air assist nozzle and making the lens dirty. But when you turn on the air assist for certain layers and software, the air assist will work at full power for these layers, which is great for laser cutting. This will extend the lifespan of the lens significantly. First, let's measure the true optical output power of this laser module. The power meter showed 41 watts of optical output power, which is above specifications. This laser module was also good at maintaining the optical power for longer duration, which means that it has good cooling system. I have also tested the output power at 20-watt power setting, where only 4 laser diodes are active in the module. The power output was spot on. Now let's start testing the Sculpfun SF-A9 with my standard plywood engraving test. I started with my standard 40-watt plywood engraving test pattern, which consists of a power scale test, which shows how well the laser engraves at different speeds. The interval test shows us how the machine performs at engraving in horizontal and vertical direction. Any difference in performance would suggest a rectangular laser dot. The photo engraving test shows us how well it can engrave photos at different power levels. I have decided to repeat this test in 20-watt mode too. I have run the test pattern designed for 20-watt engravers, which is basically the same. It is just run at half the speed of the 40-watt pattern. This way, we will be able to compare the engraving results to 20-watt engravers too. First, let's look at the 40-watt test pattern. It looks great and has a high contrast and very little smoke stains thanks to the air assist running at low speed all the time. In the interval test, we can see that the engraving performance is similar in both engraving directions. Compared to other 40-watt machines, the Sculpfun appears to have more contrast, and it performs slightly worse at low power. But there is no comparison to the 33-watt machines I have tested previously with the same test pattern. If we look at the 20-watt test pattern, we can see that it has done even darker engravings with more contrast and with zero smoke stains. Compared to other 20-watt engravers, it performed much better in my opinion, with darker engravings and better performance at all power levels. If we compare both patterns together, we can see that they look very similar, which is expected as the 40-watt test pattern has exactly twice the engraving speed. Next test on the list was anodized aluminum engraving test pattern. This test is used for measuring the laser spot size and mechanical stability, as engravings on anodized aluminum are very crisp and detailed. The test pattern includes small text engraving, engraving shapes at different speeds which tests the mechanical stability, and the main feature is the interval test in X and Y directions, which is used for measuring the focus spot size and shape. I have run this test in the 20-watt engraving mode too, to see if the laser spot gets any smaller when using only 4 laser diodes. The test patterns look great. They were both done at the same power setting in the software. This is why the 20-watt pattern looks a bit darker. Let's check them out under the microscope. Looking at the small text engravings, the lower power mode appears to really produce a smaller focus spot, which also looks more rectangular. The 3 squares are engraved at different speeds ranging from 100 to 10,000 millimeters per minute. This machine has very good mechanical stability, despite the laser head being big and heavy. Looking at the interval scale test, we can see that the laser spot size is a bit smaller with the lower powered mode, but overall, it is slightly larger than other machines in this class. We will test if this affects its cutting performance. An important thing to mention is that the Sculpfun SF-A9 has a unique feature which enables you to set the machine either in precision mode or in high speed mode. The machine is set in precision mode by default. This limits its acceleration and top speed, resulting in the highest precision and mechanical stability. But if you open up the console window, you can set the machine into high speed mode with a simple command. In high performance mode, the maximum speed of 36,000 millimeters per minute is unlocked, and acceleration is increased significantly. This allows for very fast movements. I did a short test to see how the high performance mode affects mechanical precision, but I was unable to spot the difference. Of course, when engraving small text, the difference will be greater. But in that case, it makes no sense to use high speed mode. The next test on the list is the focus distance test to see how far the laser beam retains its focus, which is an important thing to know for laser cutting. I start by placing 3 3-millimeter acrylic sheets on the laser bed and place the wood board on top. Then, I focus the laser optimally on the surface using the fine focus adjustment knob. Then, I engrave the text and the first square with 0 millimeters written in it. This is the optimal focus. Then, I keep removing the 3 millimeter sheets one by one without readjusting the focus to see how the laser beam size increases further away from the optimal focus. The first thing I noticed is how black the engravings are and how there are no smoke stains at all thanks to the minimal air assist. Compared to other laser engravers, the Sculpfun SF-A9 was the best at retaining the optimal focus at longer distances. It was even better than the Sculpfun S30 Pro Max, which held the lead with the tightest focus at 9 millimeters. But the SF-A9 has larger spot size at normal focus distance. It looks like the laser spot size doesn't diverge much with this module. This means that it should perform exceptionally well at cutting thicker materials, which is what we will test next. Now let's test how well the Sculpfun performs at cutting poplar plywood. First, I tested cutting performance on a 3 millimeter board using my standard laser cutting test pattern. This pattern is testing cutting performance at 6 different speeds, 5 different numbers of passes, and 2 power levels, all in one single job. Then I ran the same test also on 6mm board. If you want to download these test patterns, check the video description or visit my website hobbylasercutters.com. Looking at the results, we can notice that Sculpfun has the least amount of smoke stains. With the 3mm board, it has performed almost as good as the X-Tool S1, which holds the lead for 3mm performance. But with the 6mm board, the Sculpfun SF-A9 performed significantly better, thanks to the great focus retention, and it is now the fastest 40-watt diode laser cutter that I have tested so far. I have also tried to cut some black acrylic at 600 millimeters per minute. First, I tried with 3mm acrylic and Sculpfun was able to cut through very quickly, and looking at the result, we can see that it took just a bit more than one pass to cut through, which is the best result so far in this test. Then I tried it with 10mm black acrylic, and the Sculpfun SF-A9 was able to cut through in 6 passes, which puts it amongst the best laser cutters for dark acrylic. The edge looks nice, and there are very little smoke stains that were present with other machines. I also went to engrave stainless steel by engraving text at 200 millimeters per minute, and the line below at 1000 millimeters per minute. Sculpfun has produced very dark engravings similar to other 40-watt laser engravers. This engraving speed is too slow for this amount of power. Sculpfun could engrave it at much faster speed, but I do it this way to stay consistent with previous tests using weaker machines. Now let's try to cut some thicker plywood with the Sculpfun SF-A9. I tried cutting 10mm poplar plywood at 300 and 600 millimeters per minute. It was able to cut it in 1 and 2 passes respectively, which is one pass less than the nearest competitors. The cuts are nice and clean. As we can see, it is better to use faster speed and more passes, as this combination produces a cleaner cut. I have also tried cutting 18mm thick spruce board at 600 millimeters per minute, and it was able to cut through cleanly in less than 6 passes. The cut is very clean, without significant charring. I have also tried cutting the 17mm pine board at 600 millimeters per minute, which was cut with only 4 passes, which is another record. The cut edge is the cleanest I have ever seen. Lastly, I have tried cutting a 44mm thick spruce plank, where many machines have failed so far, and only the X-Tool D1 was able to cut it. The Sculpfun was able to cut it by just leaving one corner that could have contained some anomalies in the wood. This is still an impressive result. If we draw a quick conclusion, we can say that the Sculpfun made a big step in the right direction with the SF-A9. Sculpfun laser engravers have always been the best laser cutters in their power class since the introduction of the 5-watt Sculpfun S9, 10-watt S10, the 20-watt S30 Pro Max, the 33-watt S30 Ultra, and now with the 40-watt Sculpfun SF-A9. The machine is very well made and is a big step up in quality from previous models. It is also very fast and precise. The only downside is that its laser spot size is a bit larger at the optimal focus, which can affect very intricate engravings, but it surely makes up for that with its impressive cutting performance and long focus retention.